Good afternoon. This is our first ever virtual preview of an upcoming faculty meeting. So this year we have a goal of ending our monthly faculty meeting at 4. We know many of you have long commutes and we want to value your time. So rather than go directly to the auditorium for information and direction, on Monday, September 13th, you will be going directly to your breakout session. I'll go over that in a second. I do want to take some time to acknowledge and recognize the work that you each have done to prepare for a very unique school year. The months of August and September are always the busiest months of a school year. There are things that we know about and can anticipate, like all these required trainings or back to school night, but it is added work on our plates. There's also things that we don't always anticipate, like the added workload of special educators right now with the new Virginia IEP system, or a last minute change of adding lunch shifts with the new bell schedule. So I just want to thank you for your flexibility and the work that you have done over the last several weeks. I also want to remind you to prioritize your family and relationships and your personal health. Those are critical even during busy times of the year like August and September. All right, a couple pictures here from around the school, thinking about conversations that we've had during our August work days. I love seeing kids interacting. We know kids need to collaborate and communicate. That's a fundamental need of everyone, but especially adolescent learners. And I also love seeing pictures like this or observing classes or activities where kids are up and moving around the room, around the building. That is so developmentally appropriate for 6th, 7th, and 8th graders. So thank you for all your work and making experiences like this happen for our kids. All right, for those of you that are new and even returning, traditionally in our faculty meetings, we have spent some time recognizing staff in our building using a pay it forward recognition system, which is aligned to our 5 stars. This is one of my favorite things that we do here because we get to learn about all the great things happening in our building and for maybe individuals that we don't always interact with, maybe someone from food service or someone on our custodial team. We will continue this in a couple weeks when we do our faculty-led professional development. But given the topic for September 13th, we really need the full 30 minutes to address upcoming assessments that are required. So speaking of that, the measures of academic progress. So this is a diagnostic assessment. It's an adapted test that all of our students will be taking in the fall, in the winter, and the spring. We sit down, we look at the county requirements on this, and we try to divide up our days as much as possible, almost like when we do different emergency drills. We don't want it always hitting the same block at the same time of the day. So on September the 14th, which is the day after our faculty meeting, that will be our first MAP assessment, which will be math. And then the following week on an 8A, we'll be doing reading. We will be operating off of a 2-hour delayed schedule, meaning that the first 2 hours of the day will be spent with this measures of academic progress assessment. We will not have 5 lunch shifts. We will not have advisory or a 10-minute transition, not because we don't want to, but we can't fit everything into a solid day. And we want to make sure that kids are touching base with their 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, or 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th block teacher. So, as I mentioned, on Monday the 13th at 3:30, rather than come to the auditorium, you will go directly to your location. So if you are a new teacher to Riverbend, we have many people that transferred from other schools and you've worked with the MAP assessment before, but if you're brand new to our building, we want you to go to the library with Deb and Ashley. They're gonna give you everything you need to know about the MAP assessment for the 14th and the 22nd. If you're English or language arts, you will be in Aaron's room, which is B4. All the math teachers at 3:30 will report directly to B15 with Lori. And then everyone else, including myself, we will be in the auditorium with Jen and Juliet, getting all the information that we need to know. Again, we're committed to ending these meetings at 4 o'clock sharp. So in order to make that happen, I really need everyone to be in these locations at 3:30 so we can start right away and get through everything that needs to happen. So again, this is kind of a new preview for our faculty meeting. I do love seeing you in person. I love the 5-star recognitions. We will continue with that, but for Monday, 13th, it'll look a little bit different. We'll see you all in these different breakout sessions.